Hello, this is the RPG Chick, and welcome to another Let's Play. This is a shortish adventure game called Cradle. As you can tell, it was like a science fiction slant, kind of odd setting. That's about all I know about it. Playing it blind, all I did was play the tutorial. So this game came out in 2015, and yeah. Not much to say, because I really don't know anything. Going in completely blind here. So here's my quality all the way up. These are the settings such as they are. Field of view I have all the way up. I might change that. I mean, typically field of view would be 90, but we can't get up to 90 here. So we'll see how it looks. Textures are at high. Anti-aliasing all the way up. 8x. I don't know what kind of anti-aliasing this is that they're using. I had to reduce these so you can hear me, the sound and music. Mouse sensitivity seems fine for the most part. I might be changing that. The only thing is, it's kind of slow in-game, but then when you go through menus and stuff, it's quick. So I'm not sure what to do there. I'm going to leave it as is for now. These key bindings you can't change. You cannot change these. So I actually had to make an auto hotkey script to change a few of them, because, yeah. I use a tactical board, so for those who know that what that is, and that does not use WAST, or WSAD, whatever you like to call it. That's that. Authors, these are the authors. I guess it's credits. And new game. Yes, we'll take the tutorial. It's pretty quick. Oh, here we go. I think I'm in crouch mode again. Yep, to move around. Shift to run. Oh, I'm stuck. It's trying to move me when I'm not moving. Okay, we can jump. We can move even when we're not moving. Okay, we're good now. Certain objects contain text, blah blah blah. So we just run over here. I think I'm in crouch mode, so I'm gonna have to restart this, guys. So if you can't read it normally, you can read it this way. You have four different means of interacting with objects. Each has its own form of cursor. There's the eye, which you just saw, read text. See, now the mouse is flying around, but when I go to look around with the mouse, it's slower. Parentheses picks up or puts down an object. Sight, use one object on another, or dialogue cloud speak with the character. And then you hit escape to get out of that. And I'm moving. Yeah. Hopefully this is only a problem with the tutorial. Left-click on the gate, so... Certain objects can be picked up. Left-click on the red cube to pick up. And it clips with the thing. Wait, come here. Come here. Now I got it. I got a cube. You can also throw it, but they don't let you do that yet, because we're in restricted tutorial mode. So we can add that to inventory. And if we go hit that again, it's there. You can get it back, etc. Fun with inventory, and you can get things, other things. And practice adding them to inventory. Oh, goody. Oh, now, yeah, force throw. Use the force for this. Ooh. How badass. You can use certain items on others. Meaning this. Doesn't work. It wants me to take this one, I think. There we go. You may occasionally need help throughout the game. Press tab. Our story begins here, in a dream. While sleeping, you see a strange and troubled dream. Follow the instructions to wake up. Go toward the light. No, Carolyn, run from the light. So just so you guys know, I read everything. I read all the things. Aren't these pretty? Oh, I love the bass in this. Boom, 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 boom. I don't remember. Where's the light? Oh, there's a light. Isn't that the light? I mean, I'm definitely more lit at this point. We lit! I think I see... Yeah, there's a light this way. Very pretty. Ta-da! I clicked on it. New task added. I clicked the right mouse button there. What hit me? How many drinks did I have? No, I shouldn't have mixed rum and whiskey together. And gin and scotch and wine and beer. That was a bad idea. Now let's see if we get stuck again in crouch mode. I'll have to restart. This happened to me with the tutorial last time. I didn't even hardly look at anything in this room because I was stuck in crouch. And then, but I restarted the game without tutorial and it seemed fine. So you should be able, yep. You should be able to tall enough to see everything on the desk and it gets stuck. And yeah, I'm pressing crouch button. Alright, see you guys in a minute. Okay, good. See, this is our actual height. Not crouched. I'm gonna press it. Holding down crouch. Hopefully we don't have these problems anymore. Hopefully it was just a problem with the tutorial. So I got this helmet thing. I cannot move these around. Or this around. Can't move stuff around. Maybe it makes sparks come out. I'm trying to move it around kind of Skyrim mode, but yeah. I have no need for this. How rude. I'm gonna save that for last, all the stuff on that table. Candles. Incense sticks. Anything else to look at on here? I can't do anything with that. It was a good hunt. We caught 3 hares. Uncle Beertu. Get a better look at this. Great Grandma Badma. She's the Badma Grandma. Aunt Yubi. Ubisoft. And Uncle Beertu brought apricots. Sarnay with brother. This was the... Oh. Our land is undergoing great changes. Soon it will be full of people and jubilation. 2057. So I'm wondering if this is Earth or not. If so, it's very greatly changed. Uncle Ganbatar. Rocket. A flying present from Uncle Mark. At least I think it's going to be mostly changed. Kind of seems like it. No need. Oops. Did it break? It actually did not break. The chest has been shut for many years. I'm stuck in move mode. I won't open it this way. The upper chest is too heavy. Why does it do this? If I don't hold... Oh, God. That's no good. It stopped. I'm afraid to move around. Oh, we're gonna sit down? Alright. I just wanted to look at the magazine. Did I go back to sleep? Okay. I guess I went back to sleep. Alright. I must have clicked that. I want to click... What is it? Everything Magazine? Inextricable link. It's becoming wearisome to constantly refute sensational yarns of humans living with modified genocopies. We will therefore simply offer a universal fact. The neurocopy is viable only while embedded in its native inborn gene pattern. Replacing as little as a few nucleotides in your genocopy would sever this bond, and it is well documented what happens to consciousness that becomes disconnected from the body. I took that. I don't know what that is. Dreamcatcher? No. No, this is like a canteen or something. Stuffed Peppers. The famous music band presents their new album, Renew Your Flavor. The concert is timed to the anniversary of the successful modification of the empathy gene. All proceeds will be remitted to Project Transhuman Research Fund, August 17, 2043, Ulaanbaatar, Central Palace of Culture. Doors open at 1900. Huh. Now, doesn't this take place in the 2060s or something? M-body. Preparing for transfer? Get to know your new M-body. Make note of the markings of the main components. It's simple. So we got head, chest, arms, wrists, pelvis, legs, feet, fuel cell. Oh, we're like shooting off here into neurochip, geno, chip, synchronizer, accumulation container, breathing module, lens, look screen, exterior panels. Order your designer exterior panels from Felted at a promotional price. Felted. We redefine beauty. That you do. Cisterns with biological waste in the suburbs of Erdnet. All house plants need light to a varying degree. No plant can grow in total darkness. Even the bottom level of a tropical forest gets a bit more light than... I'm stuck in Kenya, Mombasa. 30 degrees Celsius all year round. Can I get off this? Can I stop moving when I'm not pressing a key? That'd be great. Grandpa Bachin has arrived. Let's make goulash. A woman knitting. Handmade flag signed, Good Hunting. A child and sheep. Sorry about this, guys. To the happy newlyweds from your parents with love. Sweet dreams and a new cradle. Oh, cradle. I wonder where the husband is. Lhasa, 2039. Returning with bounty. Oh, pictures. Okay, just stop, stop. Stop! A happy grandmother hugs her grandson. A cedar forest. Writing in Old Mongolian. First Outlines, a virtual tour of rock art monuments. Alright. Maybe if I crouch, I'll stop? Stop. Stop moving. I stopped. So happy about that. So happy I'll throw crap around. I'm telling you. I'm afraid to move now. We seem to be okay. Do I need this stuff? That would be a no. Can I take that? Wait, wait. I took it. Can I take another one? Is it just wood? Huh. Too bad I can't get descriptions on these things, at least not that I know of. I'm stuck again. Oh! I took that off. Oh god, the whole game better not go like this, and I'm stuck now. Because I auto-moved over here. Chair, move. I took that. There's a record. Vinyl record. Waves Stifling the Wind. A collection of Eastern Mongolia. 6th edition. Choibalsan Morin Kur National Orchestra 2038. 17. We're transmitting from the year 2017. Wait, wait, who we got other numbers? To those who will never explode, may your lives be rich with emotions. May your containers never cease filling. With bated breath and full of hope we gaze upon you, those whose displays proudly boast numbers higher than 70. Beyond those two digits glimmers a new hope for humankind, evicting all danger, for you will never explode. Happy day of the beautiful. Now, you know, I'm kind of wondering, I think, because I also have a gamepad plugged in. Just trying to find out where it's... Find out where, yeah, let's undo that. Let's take out the gamepad. Maybe I'll stop, yeah. Nope, I'm still... Okay. Oh, we took that off, too. What is all this stuff? No space in inventory. Well? Wait, no, it's over there, okay. Do I really need all these things of wood? Okay, whatever that is, I have it now. Can we take apart more things? We took her boobs. Okay. I'm gonna get rid of all but one of these sticks. If I need them, they're over there. Where'd this thing go? It's so small, right? Okay. Metal boobs! Huh. Wait, wait, that's not what I meant to do. This item doesn't work. If I put everything back, and then press the power button, hello there. What? Oh. Well. And we've got these with these numbers. 26, 33. Whoa, okay. I thought the game crashed. Now we're really flying around. That's that. I don't need that. I thought I was looking at one of these things. This The drug is displayed during moderate toxification of disparatoxin particles. What drug? Wait, I want to get that. Give me that. Transfer an indefinite maintenance agreement. Client, Bachin Dolha, age 69. HQ? Headquarters? 47. Provider, 30 plus transfer center. The customer sets the date and time of the transfer independently. After the body is replaced, the customer shall return rented equipment to the provider. All forms of service maintenance, including unloading of accumulated potassium, the customer shall undergo exclusively at the provider's dedicated stations. The provider shall keep the customer's evasion of good hereditary tax strictly confidential. Sets the date and time of the transfer. Does this have anything to do with the date and time? I guess I can't get that. Medical report. Patient Bachin Dolha. The procedure of disparatoxin excretion from the body was a success. Poison levels have been reduced to 60. Repeating the procedure is contraindicated. Body replacement and relocation to a new place of residence with lower contamination levels is recommended. Discounted accessories for Android decorations. A 95% blowout sale on luminescent Ikebanas from 2 seasons ago. What the hell that is? I saw a machine under the dome today. It was buzzing, putting up billows of sand and picking something up from the ground with its claws. I couldn't make out what from a distance. Its bottom hit the enclosure as it flew away. Afterward, I found strange objects nearby. They must have fallen out of its womb. I'll clean and hang them on the wall. Every tiny little piece of paper, my god. I've noticed sparks coming from a pole up on the hill. Need to remember to warn Tabaha. He shouldn't be speeding in this section. He shouldn't, huh? TV guide for December 2071. So we're in at least 2071. Future projections. This is the last chance for Project New Beginning. Could the donor abilities of the ugly put an end to the emotional burnout of the beautiful? Lucky Devils. An interview with a 20% girl outsider taken in by an upscale couple. How participating in the organ donor program brings joy to members of the lower class. In the name of beauty. Should society persecute the protection of pirated copies of Android decorations? Do we have the moral right to deprive indigent citizens of the ability to decorate their bodies with illegal HQ merchandise? Activists speak out in favor of man's inherent need to surround himself with beauty and virtue. That sounds cool. The on button is jammed. I can't press it. Oh, that's a shame. On button jammed. I don't like my on button jammed like that. So now I'm stuck in sprint mode, apparently. Deserted temple, wild with cedar. Okay, look at the mask. 3 days in Lhasa. Altai 2037. The paint is peeling. People in monastic robes. Okay, so this is another bed. Kach's Code of Salvation. Were I given the magical opportunity today to send a one-word text into the past, I should write 3513 and send it to myself. Yes, it is only 4 digits, but it would have been enough to save our world. The famous quote of Helmut Kach naturally tugs at our heartstrings. Together, when the prospects of returning to our former lives are all but nil, the thought of the chance we had missed torments us all. These days, everybody knows the number 3513. I'm gonna write that down. everybody knows the number 3513. We associate it with a spell that could have saved us all. If only it were cast in time. But how is it that four simple digits could have presented a disaster? Our exclusive interview with Professor Koch, the pioneer of neurocopying, sheds new light on previously unknown details of this tragic story. 3513. Alright, so, written down, because I'm not good at remembering numbers. Alright, what else is there to look at as we speed across this place? Oh, what's in here? I can put things in there, apparently. Maybe parts of her? Oh god, don't do that. I didn't even press that button. Oh, this is becoming unplayable. Let's go over here. Can I go over here and look at this stuff? Cube! Looks like a shoebox. Yep, I'll just randomly walk around the apartment. I'm not touching anything, guys. I'm moving the mouse. That's all I'm doing. Potassium 433. A new kid on the block of chemical elements, bringing with it both ruin and salvation. Which of the potassium's components will end up ruling a world? That depends on you, superhero. So put on your cover and get to work. Collect the sweet component to replenish the rescue fund. Destroy its bitter counterpart to safeguard the world from new emissions. The field game of the year returns. Photocopy covers P3 format. Compatible with GE series of photocopiers 1, 2, 4, and 5. What about this thing? Message on the display, lid open. Huh? Okay. Can I look at the lid here? Oh god. I'm trying to like reset this. It wants me to go a specific way. And that's it. Lid open, yes, I understand. No flower in the photocopier. Okay. We want to put a flower. Okay, can I look at this stuff here? To the center of the sphere, newspaper article. We are 1.5 kilometers outside of the contamination sphere, crossing the outer perimeter. The toxin content is low here, and the risk of damage to the nervous system negligible. We're headed toward the center. 140 meters to the sphere border. Warning signs are everywhere. Beyond this point, the exposure rises sharply. Inside the marked perimeter, the nervous system ceases operation. We are minutes away from slipping into unconsciousness. Where are they? Contamination sphere. The toxin content is low. They need toxin content. Yeah, some kind of like offshoot of the human race, right? Like hybrid? They need toxins. 40 meters to the sphere border. We have made it to the deadly frontier. We're looking at a tall enclosure. We're not going to go any further. Only mechanical equipment is capable of functioning outside the sealed-off area. Can I move this? No. 0 meters. The lens... Okay. My mouse stopped moving. I couldn't move my mouse. Alright, we're not going to go any further. Only mechanical equipment is capable of functioning inside the sealed-off area. 0 meters. The lens of our scouting drone is right at the border to the contamination sphere, marked by a gray tinge in the earth. The area on the other side is hardly researched and remains inaccessible, even for machinery. Many a mystery is hidden inside the sphere. What are the amorphous dots rising from the ground along the border? What is the cause of the sphere's ostensibly arbitrary effect on the organic human body, which disintegrates at twice the rate of all other creatures? And of course, what's happening at the center of the sphere? Jan Vujovic, expert opinion. Let me just read that, because I was... Right? Amorphous dots. We know next to nothing about the processes transpiring at the epicenter of disparate toxin emission. There's but one claim we can confidently make, that space operates under unique physical properties. Thus far, we've observed inconceivable phenomena, such as microwave radiation vanishing, pushing us to consider truly fantastical theories. One such theory suggests that a radio signal sent to the epicenter doesn't just vanish, but travels through time. Yes, of... Oh my god. I can't stand it anymore. Did I look at this? Yes. If we can stay in one place for a second. Neither courage nor fortitude play a role. The panic attack spares no one. Each subsequent second of the attack is twice as harmful as the preceding one, and whereas the damage suffered in the last 15 seconds is usually mendable with time, anything past that mark results in irreversible harm. Oh, God. I want to look at that. Let me look. Good God. I'm outside. And I didn't want to go out here. Oh God, guys, this is freaking ridiculous. Are you serious? Hold on, let me try something. Nope. Yeah! Restarting. Okay. Now, either it's the game that was screwing up or was auto hotkey. Let's see. Let's try with their default controls. It's closed. Stupid that we can't move the controls. We can't. We got clothes in here. I'm afraid to move. Plus I'm using the wrong keys. So, to crouch. Can I get that out? Is it possible? Now it's stupid, as I saw on Steam. They said they were working on it. Hockey World Championship 2039. A brilliant victory for the Mongolian national team. They said they were working on, you know, being able to let you choose your key bindings. That was in 2015. It is now 2 years later. We do not have it. That's a candle. And there's the number 20. So get more of these. We shall be grass and bushes, we shall be water and flowers. So there's peoples up there. Great-grandpa Dalha. The Zambul and Sarne. There's like a lot of detail in this game. There's a lot to look at. Ulaanbaatar. Residential houses and a square. Tibetan amulet. Ulaanbaatar at a bird's eye view. City of Choi Balsan. I'm afraid to move because I'm... A woman with a child. A sign on the back reads the Zambul. 2 years. So I can't look at any of these things, apparently. But that can open. Tibetan Book of the Dead. Ooh. Pure white flame burns so brightly, so blindingly, that it pains the eyes to behold it. Pure white flame. Oh, there's another book I can look at underneath. I can't take these books, though. Collection of Neo-Buddhist fables. Short morality tales. One of them is carefully circled with a marker. Sitarasana's Path. One night in the woods, a girl named Sitarasana had a curious thought. She suddenly realized that she didn't know who her parents were. It can't be that I don't have parents. I must have simply forgotten them, and I bet they're waiting for me back home, thought the girl. Pardon me, which way do I go to find my parents' home? Sitarasana asked a vagrant with a malcontent face. If you don't know where to go, go toward the light. That's what I always do, the vagrant replied, shaking soot off his smoking head. That's what we did in the tutorial. We went toward the light. Sitarasana looked about herself. To the east, rays of the rising sun were filtering through the tree trunks. My home must be that way, the girl decided, and headed toward the light. The sun guided her path that entire day, but then evening came and it hid beyond the horizon. The moon rose to the firmament. The girl halted momentarily, wavering, then shrugged and started after the moon. But come morning, the moon melted from the sky, replaced once more by the sun. Sitarasana frowned and turned toward the sun. We'll walk until I reach my goal, she decided. 6 days and six nights, Sitarasana wandered through the woods, alternating between the sun and the moon and changing direction until she reached a meadow flooded with a phantasmal light. Beg pardon, but where is the light coming from? I see neither the sun nor the moon in the sky, she asked Buddha, who was listening to music streaming from a radio speaker. Buddha stuck his finger in the sky and returned the volume knob to its former position. The girl looked up and saw the stars above. She smiled and thought, what beautiful music.